Welcome to my second video on kinematics. Here in this example, a ball is thrown from the top of a building with an initial velocity of 30 meters per second. And given this information, we're going to answer three questions. What is the max height of the ball? How long it's going to take till it reaches that max height? And what is the height of the building, given that the velocity of the ball before impact is 90 meters per second. But let me introduce myself before we get started with this example. My name is Chris. I'm here to help you as much as possible with all of your math and your physics needs. And I want to let you know that I do offer homework solutions. So send me pictures to homeworksolutions@mathmeeting.com. Once again, send pictures to homeworksolutions@mathmeeting.com. I'll get back to you immediately with a quote, and I would love to help you out as much as possible with all of your extra homework problems. Also, I do offer live tutoring. If you're interested in live tutoring, send an email to livetutoring@mathmeeting.com, and I would love to set something up and help you out. But let's not waste any more time, and let's get started right away with this example. All right, so let's start with question number one. What is the max height of the ball? And just to give myself a little bit more space for the time being, I'm going to erase all of the other questions. All right, so how are we going to find the max height of the ball? And once again, we're going to use our kinematic formulas, which are given to us on the left-hand side of the screen. And notice, once again, that all these formulas have four unknowns. And we are always given three of those unknowns, and we need to solve for the fourth one. So what are the three unknowns which are given to us? Well, we know that the initial velocity of the ball is 30 meters per second. So when this person throws this ball from the top of the building upwards, we know that there's initial velocity of 30 meters per second. All right, and I'll write this actually underneath so we can keep all our information organized. So we know that the initial velocity when the person throws a ball is equal to 30 meters per second. All right, so what else do we know? What else is given to us? Well, we know that the acceleration of the ball is equal to the acceleration due to gravity. We have gravity pushing down on this ball, and the acceleration due to gravity is equal to negative 10 meters per second squared. It's actually equal to 9.81, but I rounded to 10 just to make our calculations a little easier. So our acceleration due to gravity is going to be equal to negative 10 meters per second squared. And the reason why it's negative is because if our velocity going up is positive, then the acceleration going down has to be negative. So make sure to keep your signs and your units consistent. So because the acceleration is pushing down and positive is going up, we know that acceleration is going to be negative. So we have an acceleration due to gravity is equal to negative 10 meters per second squared. All right, so what else is given to us, or what else can we find out from this problem? Well, if you notice what this question is asking us, it says, what is the max height of the ball? So what's the velocity going to be at the max height? So if we throw this ball up into the air, and then it starts going down, notice at this max height, the ball is neither going up nor going down. So the vertical velocity is actually equal to zero. So we know that the final velocity when the ball reaches its max height is equal to 0 meters per second. And this is a very important concept to remember for kinematics. We know that when we're finding the max height of anything, the velocity or the vertical velocity is equal to 0 meters per second. All right, so now we have our three unknowns, and we can actually solve for what we're trying to find. We're trying to find the max height of the ball. So we just need to use one of these four kinematic formulas, and we can find the max height. All right, so which one of these kinematic formulas are we going to use? Well, we're trying to find the max height of the ball, or the distance or displacement of the ball. So we're trying to find delta x. Delta x is what we're solving for. So which one of these kinematic formulas has these four unknowns? And if you look at our kinematic formulas on the left-hand side of the screen, We know that this equation, this third one, has all four unknowns, which we have in our problem. And we are solving for delta x. So I'm going to rearrange this equation in terms of delta x. If we rearrange this equation, delta x is equal to the final velocity squared minus our initial velocity squared, all divided by 2 times our acceleration. All right, so now we just need to plug everything into our equation. And we'll start with our final velocity. Well, we know that our final velocity is equal to 0 meters per second. So I'm going to erase our final velocity and plug in a 0. So now we have 0 squared minus our initial velocity squared. And we know that our initial velocity is equal to 30. So I'm going to erase our initial velocity and plug in a 30. So I plugged in a 30 for our initial velocity and we squared it. And now the only thing we have left is our acceleration. And we know that our acceleration is equal to negative 10. So I'm going to erase our acceleration and plug in a negative 10. All right, so now we have some easy calculations. In our numerator, we have 0 squared minus 30 squared, which is equal to negative 900. And in the denominator, we have 2 times negative 10, which is equal to negative 20. All right, so our displacement delta x is equal to negative 900 over negative 20. Negative 900 over negative 20 is equal to positive 45. So our delta x, our displacement, is equal to 45. And our units are in meters, so 45 meters. All right, so what is this telling us? We know that when the person throws the ball up, and then when it starts coming down, we know that the max height before it starts coming down, this is equal to 45 meters. So I hope this video gave you a better understanding on kinematics. In my next video, we're going to talk about question number 2. How long is it going to take for the ball to reach its maximum height? So click on the video if you want to keep on learning. Once again, don't forget, I do offer homework solutions. So send me an email, send pictures to homeworksolutions@mathmeeting.com if you are interested. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next one.